visit, because we're going to talk about crypto. So this is the way I kind of explain what I do. I'm a designer by trade, but this is kind of how I explain the way I try to work. But let's make some puzzles first. Also, Jan already started a little bit. So this first puzzle, this is the EU. Three countries in the EU had CIA black sites, that's an illegal CIA prison. The names are hidden in the letters, so the three countries are hidden in all the letters. Anybody see a name of a country? It's in English, by the way, it's important to know.
Poland.
Poland's one, yeah, very good.
Hungary.
Hungary, no.
Italy.
Romania,
Poland, and then the remaining letters. Lithuania as well. It's difficult if you put all the letters together. Next one's a bit easier. The Five Eyes, the most famous spy network in the world, you might know it, since 1946. They've been spying also on a bunch of celebrities. These are five celebrities that the Five Eyes spied on. Anyone you recognize?
Lennon.
Mandela is number one, yeah.
Lennon.
John Lennon, yeah. Number four.
Sophia Ruben.
No. There's a princess. Princess Diana. And this third one, it's a bit difficult, it's Charlie Chaplin. And that's Jane Fonda. This is another one I made. It's about IFA Christmas puzzles, so I make puzzles. So IFA also always makes a Christmas puzzle, which is of course because they like puzzles and also because it's kind of a recruitment thing. I actually find it kind of interesting, the NSA does this as well actually. So, and in the puzzle of this year, or the one in 2014, they use this kind of trades, and I thought that's not a kind of good way to represent the IFA. So I made a puzzle myself with kind of trades, but more like eavesdropping cars. Because we don't know how many telephone taps the IFA does, but we know it of 1 year, 2009, because the government asked for to make this public. So this is the number of 2009 wire telephone taps. And you can deduct this number by looking at the other numbers, because they don't have the same logic. So who can kind of deduct what the number is we're looking for here? 10. That's correct. Why?
Mainly because of it.
Yeah, exactly. It's not so difficult. I mean, therefore, NSA next time, I wanted to make puzzles that people can make. Well, thank you for your cooperation. So, the reason why this came about is that I was actually looking at the Chaos Computer Club videos. I don't know if you guys know, this is in Hamburg, it's a very famous hacker conference. I unfortunately never was there, but they put all this stuff online, which is great. And in 2013, there were all these great talks about NSA technology and NSA kind of the surveillance stuff they do by Jacob Eppenbaum. So complicated and so difficult, even if you know a little bit of that, about technology, to see how what the pervasiveness and the technical advance, how technically advanced it is, right? And then I thought it's kind of strange because on one hand it's very technical, on the other hand it affects us all because everybody with a cell phone or with a laptop, you know, we are like prone to this kind of digital surveillance, right? So I thought why shouldn't I make a puzzle explaining each one of those kind of, try to explain a lot of these digital espionage tactics, and then maybe put it in the newspaper every week, and people like making puzzles, they're on a train, etc. So by people making kind of basic, simple cryptography, they can also find something out about digital surveillance, about privacy, etc. So this is the puzzle, it's very small. It was on the tech page. And I also try to, for myself, I had to make one every week, also every week try to make a complete new puzzle. So this is about the Five Eyes Network, I'll just talk to you about this. These are the silhouettes of the countries in the Five Eyes Network. This is a bit more complicated one. This is a system for the British GCHQ. They use this when foreign diplomats that are kind of suspects, when they make a hotel reservation in London, they can change the reservation to a room that's blocked. So the name of this program is in here, and every letter is one key. And the way the shape of the key reflects a number, and the number reflects a letter. So it's a bit more, takes a bit more time. You have to have a longer train ride, maybe in Amsterdam later. This is one that's about the prison program, one of the first leaks at Edward Snowden, so major American internet companies whose data is compromised. This is also a CISO cipher, the one that Jan once explained. So this is the key prison equals BDUEY, so you can find out it's basically maze. I mean, it's like a children's puzzle. But this is about the link between Huawei, that's one of the biggest telecom network companies, and the Communist Party, the government in Beijing. And yeah, the puzzle is also based on this kind of mathematical traffic salesman's problem, because it's about networks. This one, it's CAPTCHA. CAPTCHA is, of course, a visual Turing test. It's a little bit old-fashioned, from 97, come on, it's like ancient. And it's already breakable, of course, by computers. But what I like is this, the puzzle, it's the list of all the artificial intelligence programs by DARPA, which is the kind of research laboratory of the American military, so you can kind of meet the programs here. So I'm actually not so good at puzzles, I'm also not so good at math, so how did I end up doing this? I was actually, went to school, an art school in Breda, and we had this book in the library, it's very famous, from 1974. And they had these are actually made without a computer, but all these really beautiful information graphics. And I really liked the idea that from this information, you can kind of create this new world that is completely abstract, but still makes sense, you know, to some people. But I think this kind of abstraction, it can also become a kind of illustration of the world in itself. So I think it kind of like stuck with me, and I'm always interested in this kind of logic behind images. This is from Fluxus, something that I personally really like. These are musical scores from John Cage. So talk about kind of notation. Yeah, this is George Brecht from Fluxus, who kind of brought back performance into kind of one simple, it's almost like software, right? One simple mathematical rule that he could give to others and other people. Situationists, something inspired from the concrete poetry. This is from Brazil from the 1960s, where typography meets poetry and logic, also in a way. This is from Poland, Stanislav Klotz, also from the 60s, this conceptual art period. It's also from him. So this kind of coolest, oldest, one of the coolest, oldest things. So this is actually a word from Hebrew, and I had this poster on my wall, this thing, and I thought it was like a new thing, it's like really, really old. In the Roman times, people wore it around their necks, it was like this superstition thing. But it's actually from Hebrew, Aramaic, and it means I create what I speak, or as I speak. And I think this link between mysticism, religion, and cryptography is always kind of looming, so these are all NSA, operations, right? But also, this is from the NSA, this is one of their famous slides. I love those. But, I mean, the whole idea that there's this basic world out there we cannot see and that can everybody can read and we can harm people is, I mean, it's kind of visible, right? And that's also a link when I was researching into the point of view to make this puzzle every week. For example, this is from Syria, from Persia. This is religious cryptography. This is from Indian math from India, it's quite old. And there was also the spirit of mathematics in India where mathematics was always combined with a religion or spiritual forms. And that's also inspires me then to make a puzzle like this, for instance, which is about the Russian intelligence, FSB, doing stuff at Sochi during the Olympics. Or this one, these are all the countries that were claimed very renewable to join this. He actually calculated how many Islamic countries were bombed or invaded by the US since 1950. And these are some of those countries. This is Celtic knot, also a very cool kind of ancient form, which is completely closed and very complicated. So this inspires me to make a puzzle about IFID and the way they kind of go into the deep web or the dark web to find the propaganda of jihadist organizations. This is one where I was inspired by patterns from the Middle East, which are like super mathematical. Cryptography for the large part was also originated in the Middle East, especially in Iraq. And this is from Persia, for example, in Islam. And I used these shapes again in a puzzle about jihadist cryptography. Jihadist organizations, their own PGP, because I don't know, they don't want to use PGP. It's like a jihadist form. This is about cyber attacks from Russian hackers. Europe. This is one about Mexico, NSA operations there, so I'm not going to explain the puzzles now. This one I just want to show because it's the Wilhelmus. Does anybody know why this is a form of cryptography?
Is that
Yeah, the Johannes is a letter vers. It's an across God. Thank you. It's so letter vers is where if you read the text, maybe all the first letters or all the first letters of every couplet in this case forms a word. So the first couplet, all the couplets of the Johannes say Johannes van Sau. So W-I-L-L-E-M. So the guy who supposedly co-wrote the Wilhelms was also the cryptographer for Willem van Oranje during the war. Interesting story. This is one I also like, this is also acrostic, but this is from a student who was writing a paper about physics, and it's the Rick Rowley. I don't know if you explain this right. Yeah. So I like this kind of everyday simplistic form of how cryptography can manifest itself. This is one about American operations in Mali, where they do air reconnaissance missions, oh yeah, I also like this. So there was this whole news article about how NSA agents were using their company's kind of information to spy on love interests. And in a forum, there was this hashtag where people came up with these romantic comedies that were about cryptography. And there was this part to make this puzzle that was about, they call it Love Int. And this is like a famous romantic comedy, you have to like decrypt the title and who's in the romantic comedy. One of the last ones on the show, NSA was collecting 50,000 passport photos every day or something for biometric aspects. So they have a big database of passports so they can run it through their system. So what I did is I took all these Dutch politicians, some of you might recognize, it's also the book of the puzzle, and the way that biometric software will look at face recognition or face tracking will look at the faces. Of course, our Minister of Justice is also in there, and defense. So those are my puzzles. I did this for 1 year, and it was also kind of enough to see. Chance to make one every week. I'm going to make an exhibition in Dublin. I'm also going to make one in Germany with this project, doing a spy puzzle cafe where people can come in, make puzzles, win prizes, learn about cryptography, learn about safe, you know, browsing. So this is some of the puzzles I made, and hopefully soon. So that will be